the Morris River goes right through. And that's where they want to put the pipeline, right underneath that river. And
watching clips from an event that happened on December 1st. It was hosted by Divest McGill, McGill Nurses for Planetary Health, Students in Solidarity for Palestinian Human Rights, the Quebec Public Interest Research Group at McGill, Indigenous Student Alliance, and the Free City Radio. The event was calling for immediate action to support the Wet'suwet'en community, asking McGill University to divest from TC Energy Corporation, the company behind the construction of the Coastal GasLink Pipeline, which is being built through traditional unceded Wet'suwet'en territory.
As we all know that the history of the Wet'suwet'en spans back from January the 8th of 2019, when that day the Coastal GasLink put an injunction on our people on the territory of the Wet'suwet'en Nation. Gidim Dan is right in their path, because Gidim Dan is also from Unistoten, what you have seen and what you have witnessed, was where the Morris River goes right through. And that's where they want to put the pipeline, right underneath that river. And there is just no way in the world we are going to let that happen.
The speaker, Marlene Hale, speaks about the battle the Wet'suwet'en community have been fighting against the Canadian government and RCMP. Marlene also references the Maurice River. After recent escalation on the pipeline's construction that threatens the river's ecosystem, hostility between RCMP and land defenders has increased, as the government has flown in militarized police forces to arrest the land defenders.
And those little towns, they're Smithers, Vanderhoof, Prince George, and Houston, B.C., where they have all been taken over by the RCMP. Every hotel, every restaurant is donned with all of them, staying there day after day, flying them in, bringing them in by the busloads. To do what? They have spent so far between Wet'suwet'en and Fairy Creek, $7.5 million the government has paid the RCMP to do what? Just to beat on innocent people who are on the front lines looking after their own land.
Appears to be landing.
We're surrounded by tactical officers with guns. They cut off the internet.
They're outside the window.
Oh, they're outside the window. This is a private residence and you are trespassing. You need to leave now. You are trespassing against Wet'suwet'en law. Fucking
gun
off me, you asshole.
Oh, everybody's
in trouble.
Get your
hands
off of her.
You're under arrest.
This is covered with Wet'suwet'en territory.
It is deplorable at a time when Canada is looking at BC right now in the most horrific landslides to the flood stage of what it is. Or what do we call the biggest river storm in history? It's supposed to be once in a time in 100 years. Well, that's happening now. And we've lost so many towns all the way through BC.
Marlene raises a point made by many after the recent arrests. Why are government resources being allocated to fly in RCMP officers amidst one of BC's worst natural disasters in decades?
The square was chosen specifically to host the event because it's in front of the James McGill Administration Building, the meeting place of the Board of Governors.
Today we want to amplify a petition demanding that McGill University and the Board of Governors, who like to hang out in that big old building over there, that we demand that they immediately divest in its endowment investments in TC Energy, use its influences to pressure the federal government for immediate withdrawal of the RCMP.
At the time of filming on December 4th, the petition had 741 signatures. Within the petition, it is stated that it must be made clear that by investing in the TC Energy Corp stock, McGill is not only directly funding a project which violates Indigenous human rights, but also delivers a social license for this violent pipeline to operate while profiting off of said violations. Divest McGill plans to deliver this petition to the Board of Governors soon. Efforts to urge McGill's divestment have been ongoing for many years, but after the recent events, it is more important than ever.